Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you all children? I hope you all are fine. Today we are going to do a very new topic, that is integer. This is the first time you are learning about integer. So we will try to understand what we mean by integers. In our previous video, when we were doing whole numbers, I had told you two different types of numbers over there. The two different groups of numbers, that is counting numbers, or we also call them natural numbers, and the second group of numbers was the whole numbers, right? What about the natural numbers or the counting numbers? When we start from 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we call them natural numbers or counting numbers. And if we start the numbers from 0, if the group of numbers starts from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, then we call them whole numbers, okay? This we have already discussed. Today we are going to discuss another group of numbers, that is integers. Now in integers you will find positive as well as negative numbers. Now you might be wondering, what is the role of negative numbers here? See, negative numbers we use when we are talking about temperature, or if you are talking about any profit or loss in the money matters, okay? We usually use negative numbers also. For example, if you are talking about the temperature, when we talk about the temperature of say Udupi, how do we denote it, or what numbers do we use? If I have to say that the temperature of Udupi today is say 35 degrees, so how will we write it? We will write it as 35 degree Celsius, okay? Say for example, this is for Udupi. If we have to talk about the temperature of a hill station, especially in winters, have you ever heard the news when they talk about the weather forecast, and when they are talking about the hill stations or cold areas, they will usually tell you like the temperature has gone down to minus 4 degrees or maybe minus 2 degrees, right? So minus 4 degrees or minus 2 degrees, now you can see the number used here, it is having minus, that is the negative number. Okay, so we use both the types of numbers, positive as well as negative numbers. So the group of numbers that have positive and negative, both the groups in one set, we call them integers. Okay, now how do we show them on a number line? We'll try to understand. And what is the value of these positive and negative numbers also, we'll try to understand in today's class. Okay, now if you see a number line that is drawn over here, in both the directions it will go endless. That means there are endless positive numbers as well as endless negative numbers. That means you can keep on writing negative integers over here. Same way you can keep writing the positive numbers or the positive integers, okay? So negative and positive, both the numbers are infinite. Any number of positive numbers you can write, and same way the negative also. Now in between you will find 0, okay? To the right side of the 0, they are all positive integers, okay? To the right side of the 0, we write positive integers, and to the left side of the 0, we write negative integers, okay? Remember this, left side we will find all the negative integers, left side of the 0, 0 is always in the middle or in the center. And right side, all the positive integers we write, okay? Now, all the positive numbers, they go on increasing in value. As you go towards the right side, the value will go on increasing. Like 1 is smaller, 2 is greater, 3 is more greater, right? 4 is more greater. We know this, we have already studied about this. As you go towards the right, the value of the number goes on increasing. But as you come towards the left, the value will go on decreasing, okay? Here minus 1, then minus 2 is smaller than minus 1, minus 3 will be smaller than minus 2, so the value goes on decreasing. You might say that 2 is big and 1 is small, but it is minus 1 and minus 2. Say for example, if you are getting minus 1 marks, and then if you get minus 2, where will you be happy, or where will you think is better? For example, the temperature, okay, if it is minus 1 degree and minus 2 degree, minus 2 degree is more lower, isn't it? It is more lower in where compared to minus 1. So, as you go towards the left side, the value of the numbers goes on decreasing. Okay. So, here minus 1 is greater than minus 2. Minus 2 is again greater than minus 3. So, here value goes on decreasing. Okay. Now, one example that I have given you of negative and positive integers that we use is of temperature. Okay. The next example that I can give you is the level. Have you heard of the sea level, below the sea level and above the sea level? See, the above the sea level, whatever the height we measure, like height of the mountains and all, that will be positive. We use positive numbers over there. Say 2000 meters above the sea level. So, when we say above the sea level, it is positive integers that we use or positive numbers. Same way when we talk about below the sea level, you know, when we talk about the depth of the sea, how deep it is, that time we say below the sea level, say 1000 meters below the sea level. Now, there the 1000 meter is negative, minus 1000 meters we use. Okay. So, this is the second example where we use negative and positive integers. Same way if you are talking about profit and loss, profit of 50 rupees, it is a positive number. So, we will write it as positive. Okay. Gain, it has increased. Okay. When we talk about loss of 100, loss means it is negative, becoming less, right? So, this is a negative integer or negative number. Negative means it will become less in value, positive will be more in value. Okay. Now, 40 degrees Celsius, it's a positive integer. Okay. Same way, below 0 degrees Celsius, see, anything that is below 0 will be negative. Say, for example, 2 degrees below the 0 degrees Celsius. So, 2 minus 2 degrees is what we are going to write. Whenever we are writing the value below 0, it will be negative. Okay. Always remember, if you have something like below 0, means it is a negative integer. Clear? Now, let us see how we compare these integers. When we have positive and negative numbers, how do we compare? Comparing of numbers we have already done, isn't it, in your previous classes, right from class 1 you have been comparing the numbers, which is greater, smaller and equal. The signs also you are familiar with, right, greater than, less than and equal sign. Now, using the same signs, we will see how we compare the integers. Okay. Now, here I have the first example that I have is 5 and 8, both are positive integers. See, if nothing is written with the number, that means it is positive. Okay. If we do not write plus also, it does not matter. It is not necessary that every time you have to write the plus sign. If it is not there, it is understood that it is a positive integer or a positive number. Okay. So, now 5 and 8, which is greater? 8 is greater than 5, is not it? 5 is less than 8. Now, next example that I have here is minus 8 and 6. Minus 8, it is a negative integer, right? And 6 is a positive integer, is a positive number. Now, which is more in value? Positive number will be more in value or negative number will be more in value? Obviously, the positive number will be more in value, it will be greater, isn't it? So, here minus 8 is again smaller than 6. 6 is the greater number because it is positive. Okay. The positive numbers are always greater than the negative numbers. Next, here I have two numbers which are negative, minus 4 and minus 9. Now, which one will be greater? Minus 4 will be greater or minus 9 will be greater? If you look at this number line, we have minus 4 closer to 0. The numbers that will be close to 0 in the negative side, that will be greater in value. Okay. This will be, in this way you can keep it, it will be easy for you to understand. The numbers that are close to 0 will be greater in value. As they go far from 0, the value will become less. Now, we have minus 4 here. Minus 9 will be somewhere after 2, 3 numbers, somewhere here, right? So, it is moving far from 0. So, which number is closer to 0, minus 9 or minus 4? minus 4 is close to 0, isn't it? So, minus 4 will be more in value compared to minus 9. So, here minus 4 is greater than minus 9. Okay, I have told you in negative integers, as you go far from 0, the value will go on becoming less. It will have less value. Now, next, the last example that I have here is minus 2 and 0. Which one will be greater? 0 or minus 2? As you move towards the left side, the value goes on decreasing. So, 0 is first, after that is minus 2. So, 0 is more in value compared to minus 2. Okay? So, 0 will be greater than minus 2. I hope you have understood how we compare the positive and negative integers. Even 0 will be having more value than the negative integers. So far in whole numbers and whatever we discussed, 0 was having the least value, isn't it? But in integers, there are numbers which are much less in value than 0, the negative integers. Okay. Now, let's see how we arrange these integers in ascending and descending order. Ascending order means small to big. Okay, the smallest number we have to find. I have 8, 4, 0, minus 9, minus 2, 3 and minus 1. The negative integers are also there. If you are talking about the smallest, we have to look at the negative integers first. Okay, so negative integers, we have minus 9, minus 2 and minus 1. Which one will be the smallest? Minus 9. Okay, the more far it is from 0, it will be less in value, right? So, minus 9 is far from 0 compared to minus 2 and minus 1. So, minus 9 is the least, then next minus 2, next will be minus 1, then we have 0, okay? So, 0, after that the positive integers will start. And positive integers, I have 8, 4 and 3. So, which is less? 8, 4 and 3, 3 is less, then 4 and then 8. This is how we arrange the integers in ascending order from small to big. Same way descending order. When we talk about descending order, we have to start from the greatest number. So, greatest number means we will be starting from the positive integers. If we have negative and positive together, we first look at the positive integers when we talk about greater numbers. And when we talk about smaller numbers or less value numbers, then we have to look at the negative integers first. Okay. So, here we have to arrange the greater numbers. So, that means we will first arrange the positive integers. Okay. In positive integers, I have 4, 5 and 12. So, which will be the greatest in the value? 12. After that, 5, then 4 and then I have 0 also, so write 0. Next, we will look into the negative integers. Okay, in negative integers, I have minus 1, minus 6 and minus 10. In minus 1, minus 6 and minus 10, which will be having more value? We are looking into more to less, right? Big to small. So, which one will have more value? Which one will be closer to 0? Minus 1. Okay, so minus 1 is greater in value than minus 6. Minus 6 is next closer compared to minus 10. Minus 6 is closer to 0. So, minus 6 and then minus 10. Okay, I hope you have understood what are integers and the two different types of integers that we have, positive and negative. Their value decreases as they go towards the left. Okay, when we move towards the right, the value of integers increases, and as we move towards the left, the value of integers goes on decreasing. Okay, and 0 is always in the middle of the numbers, the two different numbers that we have, 0 is always in the center. Okay, and there is no end for positive or negative integers. Keep practicing, children, and inshallah I'll come back with the same topic with new concepts very soon, inshallah. Jazakallahu khaira. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.